I rise today to urge a no vote on House Bill 818. Don't tread on me. I've seen those words all over the Capitol today. House Bill 818 aims to control how Pennsylvania's women and families may utilize their own money when purchasing health insurance within the federal health care exchange. Let me repeat that, their own money. Mr. Speaker, how would all the supporters of the Second Amendment react to a bill that said they couldn't use their money to purchase insurance for their guns in Pennsylvania? Current law already prohibits the use of Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars for abortion services pursuant to the Pennsylvania Abortion Control Act. Likewise, current law prohibits federal taxpayer dollars from being used to fund abortion services, other than in the case of rape, incest, or the life of the mother. Therefore, Mr. Speaker, if no Pennsylvania taxpayer dollars may be used to fund abortions, and no federal taxpayer dollars may be used to fund abortions, then I am very puzzled by what we are facing here with House Bill 818. I wonder if it is really the intention of this chamber to limit how individuals may spend their own personal money. And if so, I challenge where this line of thinking will end. House Bill 818 sets a precedent, Mr. Speaker, and it seems it is meant to send a message to Pennsylvania's women and families that government does have a right to determine how they spend their personal health care dollars, at least when it comes to insurance coverage for abortion services. However, Mr. Speaker, this line of thinking flies in the face of those who believe that government should play less of a role in individuals' lives. Voting yes on this bill would also fly in the face of those who often like to argue that government has no place in mandating educational standards, or that we should not be in the business of building roads or funding prescription drug programs for seniors. For those legislators here today who hold true to the principle of government having no place in interfering with an individual's personal freedoms, they cannot vote yes on this bill today. Well, I guess they can, but they're going to have a hard time defending themselves back in their districts as a champion of individual liberties and freedom, Mr. Speaker. This is not just an anti-abortion bill. This bill strikes at the very core of what so many members hold true to their very basic political beliefs, the belief that government has no place in controlling personal rights, liberties, and freedom. Mr. Speaker, I urge all those members who are considering voting yes on this bill to be very aware of the action that they're taking here on the House floor today. A yes vote on this bill is a policy statement in favor of limiting personal freedom, liberty, and legal rights. Mr. Speaker, this chamber should not be treading on the women of Pennsylvania.